It's NDA versus Mahagathbandhan, remember, in five constituencies of Bihar in the fourth phase. And the one that everyone is looking at is the battle for Begusarai. Overall turnout in Bihar, 15.16%, but all eyes on Begusarai, where you have Kanhaiya Kumar, the former JNU SU president, contesting on a CPI ticket. And he is taking on Union Minister Giriraj Singh. Both Giriraj and Kanhaiya have cast their votes and they spoke to us. Listen in.
मुझे पूरी उम्मीद है इस बार बेगूसराय के लोग अपने मान सम्मान के लिए देश के संविधान के लिए और उनका जो बेसिक मुद्दा है शिक्षा और रोजगार के लिए स्वास्थ्य के लिए सबके अधिकार के लिए मतदान करेंगे बेगूसराय जीतेगा और बेगूसराय को अपमानित करने वाली ताकतें हारेंगी
आपकी लड़ाई किससे
हमारी लड़ाई उन ताकतों से है जिसने इस बेगूसराय की मिट्टी को अपमानित करने का काम किया है हमारी लड़ाई सीधे तौर पे सरकार के उस मुखौटे से है जो काम नहीं करते हैं सिर्फ और सिर्फ अपने विरोधियों को बदनाम करते हैं
कन्हैया कुमार ने अभी वोट करने के लिए पहुंचे हैं कह रहे हैं टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग के हम लोग नहीं है जनता आपके टुकड़े टुकड़े करेगी इस चुनाव में
देखिए हाथ कंगन को आरसी क्या अब तो बूथ पर पता चल जाएगा जनता किसके साथ है जिसको भरोसा था बेगूसराय की जनता पर वो बेगूसराय की जनता पर भरोसा किया जिसको भरोसा था बाहर से वार्ड वापसी गैंग को वो बाहर से लाया मुझे पूरा पूरा 200% ने 1000% है कि ये बेगूसराय की जनता की जीत हो
Let's go straight across to Sanjay Jhan, Aman Sinha to get their reactions to that battle for Begusarai. First to you, Aman Sinha. Is this the way this election is being run? Tukde tukde gang. Even the Prime Minister uses it. Kanhaiya Kumar is a citizen of India. He's contesting the election. You can differ with him ideologically, but to call him tukde tukde gang, is this the kind of language that befits, you believe, a member of parliament, a sitting member of parliament and minister?
Rajdeep, first of all, Mr. Kanhaiya Kumar, I believe, is not even in the strong contention as far as Begusarai is concerned. He is not there in the top two candidates. Clearly, Mr. Giriraj Singh is winning there hands down. I have been there on ground also, and therefore, I can tell you with much confidence. As far as your question of Tukde Tukde Gang is concerned, this was a slogan which was coined by Mr. Kanhaiya Kumar. So this question should be posed to him. Obviously, the court has also come to a conclusion. There is a charge sheet which has been prepared by the Delhi police, which is yet to be given clearance by the government
he's
of
not
Delhi.
He is not being charged or convicted. To use the words on this.
Very
apt word. You believe it's apt. Okay, you believe it's apt. Therefore, then respond, Sanjay Jha.
I have not said that. But I have said that charge sheet has been made on these grounds. And Delhi government is yet to give their consent to this.
Okay, respond, Sanjay Jha.
Let Sanjay Jha now respond. And other investigative authorities.
Sanjay Jha, how do you see this battle for Begusarai?
Why did one but several
Sir, your point.
That these kind of slogans like Bharat Tere Tukde Honge was being shouted by Mr. Kanhaiya Kumar and company.
Okay, 1 minute. We'll discuss that. Whether that's
complete.
1 minute. No. I need to give the other side equal time. Sanjay Jha. Your party, instead of supporting Kanhaiya Kumar, which you did when the agitation took place in JNU, backed off because Tejaswi Yadav did not want to support Kanhaiya Kumar. Have you all made a mistake by actually, this is one of the many mistakes maybe the Congress has made in this election, not supporting a candidate who was taking on Mr. Modi, the anti-BJP vote will be split.
Rajdeep, I don't want to comment on what were the dynamics behind Kanhaiya not getting support from the other parties. But I do want to tell you one thing. Since the BJP talks about Tukre Tukre gang in Mumbai, where I live, the issue ever since Narendra Modi has started, you know, backing, firstly appointing Sadhvi Pragya Singh Thakur and the BJP backing them almost brazenly and shamelessly, Mumbai is angry because they know that the BJP is a pseudo-nationalist party. Hemant Karkare's death, a martyr, 2611, I live in Mumbai, I was here. Hemant Karkare was slaughtered in cold blood by terrorists. And you have the BJP mocking him. The BJP has actually called him an anti-national. The BJP said, we cursed him to death. You think this is not an emotive issue just in Mumbai and Maharashtra, it's all over the country. So people have realized that this party can stoop to the lowest common denominator to try and create this whole hyper-nationalism story, even sacrificing a brave man. I mean,
are you telling me Hemant Karkare is an issue in Mumbai this time? Are you telling me that the fact that Sadhvi Pragya has been given a ticket is reason enough for you to take up the issue of Hemant Karkare? Are you suddenly saying that that's a big issue?
I'm telling you, it is a massive issue. You know, this is something that the BJP probably has underestimated. But I can tell you, every citizen of Mumbai, wherever they are from, local, immigrant, caste, community, forget all that. Everybody knows Hemant Karkare died on that night.
For what?
He tried to stop Kasab and the other terrorists. And you are mocking him? You're mocking him? This is an immediate trigger for the defeat of the BJP in several seats of Mumbai, if not all. I can tell you, even Mumbai North, I didn't get a chance to come in. Urmila Matondkar has fought a great campaign.
Rajdeep.
And Nikhil Wagle is not correct. Congress won in 2004. Sanjay Nirupam won in 2009. 14 wasn't, yes, I agree, an extraordinary aberration. Wo ab nahi hone wala hai.
Okay,
and I can tell you, you're
one minute.
From Mumbai.
Sanjay Jha, we have limited time today. We have limited time today, so I want sharp answers. Aman Sinha, you tell us.
Sure.
The context, you have today called Kanhaiya Kumar once again anti-national tukde tukde gang. And yet you are backing the woman who has targeted someone who was given an Ashok Chakra posthumously, Hemant Karkare. And today, according to the likes of Sanjay Jha and the Congress party, this is an issue in Mumbai. That while we look at Begusarai, look at the echoes in Mumbai. Who's national and who's anti-national? Who's going to decide that? Is it the sole prerogative
Rajdeep,
of your party, sir?
As Sadhvi Pragya is concerned, she has withdrawn her statement. She had expressed regret.
What's the
for
point
it
in withdrawing
she
after making such
that
an outrageous
but let me
statement?
Say, those who mocked.
What is the point in withdrawing such an outrageous
was
statement?
Foremost, Mr. Digvijay Singh. Mr. Digvijay Singh, Mr. Sanjay Jha is saying that Kasab came over, but Mr. Digvijay Singh has gone on record to say time and again that this was all saffron terror. He has been floating conspiracy theories. So therefore, who has mocked martyrs of 26/11? It was Mr. Digvijay Singh and the Congress party.
Okay.
And if at all this has to be an issue, then Congress party is going to be summarily defeated on all these six seats because
Rajdeep,
the conviction of the Congress party
Rajdeep
on national security
okay,
issues
I'm going to,
is
I'm going
not
to now,
one and
seconds.
All.
No,
after
no,
26/11, they did not choose to attack Pakistan, go across LOC,
can I,
despite specific
Rajdeep,
requests.
Give me 15 seconds, sir.
So very quickly, Mr. Jha, we need to move on very quickly.
And you start
Aman Sinha, you made your point.
No,
now, Mr. Jha.
Please do not expose your bias.
Okay, Mr. Jha, quick response.
Yeah, Rajdeep, very quickly, since Narendra Modi and the defense minister say there has been no terror attack since 56 inch ki chhati became Pradhan Mantri, so they are basically the most anti-national party. They are saying that Uri, Pathankot, Gurdaspur, Pulwama, Pakistan did not do it because there has been no terror attack. I mean, you can't have a more stupid, grotesque, bizarre and outright outlandish political party in government. They at one time
point
say that we are very nationalistic.
It would be better
they
if it
Pakistan.
Sanjay Jha.
I mean, this
that's
is no terror
no
attack.
Conviction.
What
okay, producer,
party talk.
Okay, both sides have had equal time.
BJP
we have to move
on.
71 seats are voting today.
The party
let's,
which
coined
the term saffron terror, the party.
Mics down. Okay, I've heard both sides. Javed Ansari, let's look at though the hard reality. The fact is, the Congress balked at supporting Kanhaiya Kumar. Because they perhaps didn't want to be identified this time with someone who is seen by the BJP to be part of the so-called anti-national. They were conscious that the BJP would use Kanhaiya Kumar, the likes of Kanhaiya Kumar, to perhaps tar the Congress with the garb of that you are soft on nationalist issues. Was that the reason why Kanhaiya was denied the ticket? Or did Tejaswi Yadav exercise a veto? He saw Kanhaiya as a competitor.
Rajdeep, let's get our facts right. The fact is that seat, Begusarai, was in the RJD's quota. The Congress did push for Kanhaiya. At one stage, they said, we are even willing to put him up from our quota. But Mr. Tejaswi Yadav and his party put their foot down They said, we have a much stronger candidate. He's a loyalist. He's worked his way up the ranks in our party, and we would want to reward him with a seat. That's why Kanhaiya Kumar has not found place as a part of the Gathbandhan.
Okay. Yes, Rahul, very quickly.
This is a seat which the RJD won in the Modi wave. Which political party gives up a strong seat in a same coalition for somebody else? Yes, Begusarai is Leningrad of Bihar. The CPI had a presence there. The CPI, if tomorrow today wants to use this ground, Tejasvi cannot give up his own seats. It's a make or break election, Rajdeep, where people are not contesting all 40 seats. People are sharing seats. So Tejasvi couldn't be expected. Yes, there is a factor. Somewhere Tejasvi does not want maybe perhaps a young leader coming up who speaks a similar language of the masses, not the classes. And that is why I think the contest here is, the idea eventually is to hurt Mr. Giriraj Singh, because the most dominant caste are the Bhumihars in this region. Even the Muslims are a very distant second in Begusarai. Okay. Now, if this Bhumihars are getting split, it helps the RJD, so it helps the opposition. So I don't think the Congress is really worried about that fact. The idea is that this seat will not go to the BJP.